r/AskReddit, what's the dumbest thing you actually believed? As a kid, my sister told me that we had an older brother that died. She said he died when playing bowling and his fingers didn't come out the ball and slid all the way down the alley, then he turned into a skittle. Skittle is another word for bowling pin, if that makes more sense. I used to think that people exclusively wore hats if they were bald, because that's why my dad wore a hat. My dad is bald but has always had a beard, since I've known him. Anyway, he was also a serviceman. He used to tell me that the reason he was bald was that he stood on a landmine which blew the hair off the top of his head and it slipped round to give him the beard instead. As a child I was just like, yep, makes sense. Hair not on head, hair in chin. That's gravity for ya. He also told me that a scar on his leg was from a gunshot wound. 20 years later I got a bug bite on my leg that got infected. Sorry, hope you're not eating. And left a perfectly round scar in the same place as his. I commented on how much my bug bite skull looked like his gunshot wound scar and he said, what? Is that what I told you? No. This was a bug bite that got infected. Ah. Dads. That reindeer wasn't an actual animal but specifically a mythical animal that Santa Claus used. I believed this until I was 23 or so when I saw some nature documentary talking about reindeer. I was like, why are it? The reverse unicorn. Ah. Santa and Mrs. Claus's favorite position. I thought that was going up the chimney. More so naive and innocent rather than dumb but still funny. My dad used to tell us kids that a dwarf little person worked in and operated every car park barrier in the world. Every time he drove up to one he'd press the button for the ticket and say, cheers mate, how's the wife? And fake a conversation as he waited for the barrier to open, lol. That's fantastic. He sounds like a great dad. Did he do this at ATMs too? I was convinced that Greeks still worshipped Zeus and other gods for a while after I heard the word Greek Orthodox Church as a kid. This reminds me of another stupid thing I believed. When I was in middle school I watched a documentary about Gothic churches. I believed that goth was a religion. I asked a couple goth friends at the time about fire religion. They played along for a while that day. Until finally I realized they were laughing at me. I later realized Gothic is describing the architecture of the church. My friends never let me live that one down. When I was a little kid, I believed that when people got divorced, they had a divorce ceremony. Like where they had to go to church and say, I don't. And I imagined the woman wore a black divorce dress, like her wedding dress had been dyed black. And that everybody went to the reception where the ex-bride and ex-groom sat on opposite sides of the hall and there was a divorce cake where the little bride and groom on top had their backs to each other with their arms angrily crossed. I eventually learned, from watching my mom's soap operas, that this was not the case, and was kind of disappointed cause I'd been to a few weddings by then, and was interested in what a divorce ceremony was like. Can these exist? Only in couples that split amicably, in instances of cheating, abuse, intense legal conflicts and hard feelings, which are incredibly common, even when relationships were good. I can't foresee this becoming a tradition. My dog went to a farm until I was 35. I had two turtles for over 10 years until I went off to college. My mom told me she found a turtle lady that takes in unwanted turtles and that they live in a nice big pond area in her backyard. Believed her because my mom isn't the type to lie. A few years later I started to question it though because of the pet sent to her farm stories as I'd heard other people tell. I confronted my mom about it and she maintained that she told the truth. I did some digging and found out that there actually was a turtle lady in our city. I went for a visit and sure enough, my turtles were there, along with a ton of others. So I guess sometimes these stories have a happy ending. My mom actually is a turtle lady, and the whole time I was growing up people would bring us turtles and tortoises and shit and my mom would take them in. Most of the time she would go on to find other homes for them, but there are still like half a dozen or so tortoises in the backyard. And she still takes turtles in but for the most part it's all slowed down. I believed my uncle's roommate just slept on the couch. We lived with our uncles for a while when my mother worked on the pipeline. I thought they were so selfless by sharing a bed so us kids could have the other bedroom. I would be a teen before I learned that one of my uncles wasn't my uncle. He was just my uncle's lover. When I was little, I genuinely believed the Teletubbies were evil and that if I didn't watch them on TV every night, even though I hated the show, that they would come and get me. To be fair though, they're kind of creepy. I thought that teachers lived at school. As a kid, I thought that the world wars were like battle royales where there were no alliances, no surrenders, and just pure bloody violence between every country on earth. For example, I thought every country fought all of its neighbors simultaneously. Agreed. I also thought there was a World War III and always wondered why my mom didn't buy their box set of documentaries for it like she did for the first two. There was an ad for it on the TV. Probably World War II thinking back. I thought guys got periods too, but only once, and you bled and then you were able to impregnate someone. I cut my upper leg during a rugby match and was bleeding near my groin and was devastated because I thought everyone would presume I had my period mid-match and also subsequently would be walking around able to impregnate people. The worst thing is, I wasn't even a stupid kid. We literally just lived in a reserved country and I was a full-time boarder at my school. So never got the talk, anyway. Thanks for attending my bled talk. One of my favorite songs growing up was TLC's Don't Go, Jason Waterfalls. You're Not Alone, except it was Go Go Jason Waterfalls for me. The dark meat and white meat come from two different birds. I was 12 when they asked me, as they did each year at Thanksgiving, which kind of meat I wanted. That year, I said, dark meat, please. But I feel bad, I'm the only one who really eats it and you always have to get an entire second turkey just for me. I'm still teased about it to this day, at 46 years old. That reminds me of 4-year-old me that hated celery, but after my mum told me that these green things on my plate were actually Italian well crabs, I ate it like candy. My sister still makes fun of me 17 years later. That sperm were the size of tennis balls and would burst forth from the head of your penis if you slept with a woman. Slither across the bed up into her, and make the baby. Thanks Facts of Life pop-up book with no adults willing to clarify that the objects within were not always to scale. I didn't know jizz was a thing, so I figured it kinda released spores like a fungus. To be fair, I was like 6. That if you ask someone if they're a police officer, they have to tell you the truth. There are still people who believe this. Whoever started this urban legend is a genius. Probably started by a cop. Nope. I knew the guy who started it, and I asked him if he was a cop. He wasn't. When we played Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, my little sister used to accept the lamest missions and not get good rewards. I told her about it and she responded with, "How would you like it if you were a poor Pokemon that lost its mom and was stuck all alone and had nothing to give someone to save you?" I laughed my head off at her because it's not real. But secretly, I feel that in my soul sometimes. Bro, your little sister is a real gamer. Until I was way too old, I didn't know vaginas existed. I thought women just had blank space there and all births were C-sections. I thought Churchill was an architect because when I was little my mum told me he was one of the architects of Israel. Well, she wasn't that off. A watermelon apple tree will grow out of my stomach if I eat the seeds. Well, a man actually had a pea plant grow in his lungs, so you weren't that far off from the truth. If you ignore bullies, they will leave you alone. I grew up in a Jewish household but was aware of the whole Christmas thing. It was my understanding that Santa would go around bringing gifts to kids if they left out a plate of cookies and some milk for him. It seemed easy enough. 'Twas the night before Christmas and I left the perfect food arrangement out for Santa, thinking in spite of my religious beliefs, he might leave me a gift in exchange for the snacks. When I awoke the next morning, the cookies and milk were gone but no present was left. I was furious. How dare this jolly fat man come into my hole, steal my food and not leave anything in return. I spent years complaining about it and would curse the man's name if I saw him. Of course, years later my dad admitted that he had eaten everything. Thanks Dad. Turning you against Santa from a young age, to perpetuate the war on Christmas. Clever. When I was a kid, my mom told me that people actually had gray skin in the old days for real, and that no color except black, white or gray ever existed back then. I believed that for way too long. 17. When I first saw the colorized photo of Charlie Chaplin, I was shocked. Then Gaston told me that no, people were indeed, the same back then as we are now. Only the photos and videos were captured in black and white because of lack of technology. That being named Johnny was a sin. There's a part of the song The Devil Went Down to Georgia that goes, "My name's Johnny and it might be a sin. But I'll take your bet." I instantly associated the name with being a sin, not making bets with the devil. This made me think kids named Johnny were sons of devil worshippers. I was a very dumb kid. Someone convinced me for like 5 seconds that unicorns were real. They just lost their horns through evolution and now they are plain old horses. OMG, I actually have a good one for this. My parents were super open about talking to me about sex reproduction from a young age. My mom always said, "If you're old enough to ask the question, you're old enough to hear the answer." Well, I am just a super curious person, so of course I would ask a variety of questions about sex and where babies came from during my elementary school years. My parents kind of revealed parts of it to me over time, of course, telling me the most basic things first that I could really understand. So, I knew that the sperm from a man, which came from penis, would go inside the woman's vagina and fertilize an egg, which would grow into a fetus. Cool, how did the sperm get in there? Well, I truly thought it just flew through the air, like little birds or perhaps a butterfly, up and into the woman's vagina. I did realize the logistical problems with this though. How does the sperm get through your clothes? And does the woman have to wear a dress? Well, I had questions, mom had answers. When I asked her how the sperm managed to float magically from the man's penis and somehow find its way into a woman's vagina, my mom gave me the most horrified look. She realized she left out the part about intercourse. I think, I'd love to ask her now if she remembers this. Sadly, she died in 2016. I'll never forget sitting in the bottom of the stairs with my mom, her looking down at me saying, Brantley, you don't know how the sperm actually gets into the vagina? What? No, they fly. Number. The boy and girl have to have sex. Okay, the penis has to go in the vagina. Cue my world exploding. Everything made sense. Masturbation made sense. Sex scenes in movies made sense. So many jokes that went over my head. I exclaimed, loud enough to echo through the house. Ooh. Dogs equals boys and cats equals girls. I don't know. It made sense to me as a kid for some reasons. That there was an incredibly fat, slimy dinosaur called a Blopiosaurus. I even made a whole report about it in kindergarten, based entirely off of the information my oh-so-intelligent and generous stepfather told me. So my dad used to say he was at gym until like 11 p.m. 3 times a week. My dad was pretty fit, so I naively believed him, as did my other 4 siblings. You can see where this is going, right? One day my boyfriend, now husband, was hanging out with me, and my dad came in late as usual and greeted us. After my dad went upstairs, my boyfriend asked me why my dad always gets home so late, and I told him he goes to the gym after work. He looked at me like I was an idiot, rightfully so, and said, "He's at the gym from 5 p.m. 11 p.m. Come on, you don't believe that, right?" I told him I did. My husband shook his head, and that was that. Until a few years later, when two of my sisters came to my apartment and told me that dad was cheating on mom with a co-worker and had been even since we were little kids. I felt like a fool. There had been so many weird things about my dad that I brushed aside in my mind. I remember when I was really young, I overheard my parents arguing and my mom talk about a divorce. I remember crying at the top of the stairs thinking about that and then asking my mom and dad later why they were getting divorced. My dad got so mad at me, he yelled at me and accused me of lying. I was maybe 6 years old at the time, and I remember feeling so confused and hurt and that maybe I was crazy and made it all up. Then there was the whole going to the gym thing 3 nights a week for 6 hours at a time. Also, my dad always liked to make himself look like the victim whenever my parents would argue, and they did so constantly. My mom didn't deal well with him cheating but didn't want to divorce him because she still loves him and for the kids. She went from being a very loving and enthusiastic mom to abusing alcohol and pain pills and being angry all the time. My relationship with my mom wasn't the best for a long time. I loved her, but I didn't see her pain. I just saw her anger, her mean streak, her craziness. And my dad used that whenever they would fight. He would act so damn innocent and make my mom out to be the villain every time. I actually think that was what hurt me the most when I found out, knowing how much my mom had suffered alone and how my dad used against my mom in arguments so we would always take his side. My mom was not innocent in this though. She was an adult. She made a choice to stay and endure, and that broke her. Both my mom and dad could have made the correct choice at any time, but they didn't. And everyone was made more miserable as a result. Too long didn't read. Dad was at the gym for 6 hours after work 3 days a week, and my siblings and I believed this lie for 10 plus years before we discovered the truth. That WD-40 meant windows down. 40 miles per hour. Someone told me that in middle school as a joke, and I took it literally until I was a senior. That people would be more intelligent, well informed, and more rational as internet access became more widespread. I hope maybe it's still gonna happen with the next generation. But the older I get, the more everyone seems either petty, childish, selfish, stupid, or a combination of all of the above. My father and I used to mess with my sister as she was growing up. When she saw an orange tree for the first time, the oranges were unripe and very green. We then told her that all of the citrus fruits came from the same tree, and depending on when you picked them, that was the fruit you got. They started as limes, then ripened into lemons, which would grow into oranges, and then if left too long would grow into grapefruits. She graduated with honors from a major state university this year. We found out that she still believed this during our family trip to Mexico last spring, 2019, when we had to break the news to her. There's a girl I know who doesn't believe in space. Yeah, I said it. Space. Like what's beyond the sky. She does not believe it's real and that the stars are fake. My employer cared about me. Funny story. I didn't actually believe this. My sister did. Me and my sister were 3 and 4. I was thirsty one day and wanted lemonade. My sister, who felt really bad because I got in trouble for trying to sneak a drink, wanted to give me lemonade. So, 5 minutes later, she gave me the lemonade and I drank all of it. After drinking all of it, I realized it wasn't lemonade. My sister thought that urinating in a sippy cup would make lemonade. I basically grew up on the beach. It took me 3 decades to work out that the tides go in and out twice in a 24-hour period. I am from a Muslim country. There are mosques everywhere. So we always hear as an azan, called to prayer. I used to believe that Allah, God, was reciting the azan. So I was like, I can't understand how we can't know what God is like, what he looks like, and that we can only meet him in the afterlife. Just trap him down when he leaves the mosque after he finished reciting the azan? That turkeys drowned by looking at the sky during a rainstorm. I am dumber than a bag of hammers. When I was a little kid, my grandfather had a small BW TV in the kitchen that he'd watch as he cooked meals. One day I asked him, if the rest of the world is in color, why did he keep that TV if it was broken? And he didn't know what I meant. I said, when the world changed to color, all the other TVs became color, but that one didn't. So why did he keep it? I believed, from old photos and old TV shows, that the whole world was once in black and white, and one day it switched over to color, and all the old BW TVs, except for the one in my grandfather's kitchen, had switched over to color TVs too. My grandfather got a good chuckle out of it after I had explained my thinking. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.